We'll come right around here in front of her, I think. She's going to be in the front row of my show. It's going to make it look all up a bit.
In your pockets, you will have a good sickle. Everyone, thank you.
My name is James Bowen. I recently wrote a book called A Street Cat Named Bob. And then one day he followed me onto a bus. And obviously that was quite frightening because there's a lot of traffic. So I got him a special harness. And he wears it every single day and he goes with me everywhere. Well, we probably get up about 7:30, 8 in the morning. We usually head out about 9:30, 10 in the morning, get to the West End for about 11, 11:30, because it's a long journey on the bus. Living with my my sister over here, and things didn't work out so well, and then things started tumbling into bad places, you know, just the roll of the dice weren't good, I suppose you could say, and I ended up sleeping rough, and then I started using drugs to escape reality, because it's not nice sleeping on the street, so you look for any kind of comfort you can. And from there things just got worse until eventually I got into a housing program, which has basically brought me to where I am now. And then obviously I met Bob when I moved into my housing program. And as you know from reading the book, things have changed quite dramatically for me.
It is going to number one in the bestsellers this weekend, which is absolutely incredible. So there's, how did the book come about?
Well, basically I was selling the big issue in Angel Area. I'm back up once you hit rock bottom, but I'm definitely on the way back up now.
So he turned you around.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. You know, it's still the honeymoon period of the book, isn't it? You know, and as you can see, it's selling quite well. And I am so incredibly amazed that so many people are buying my book. It is wonderful. And I am just so grateful to every single person who buys my book. You know, if anybody ever wants to come up to say hello to me and Bob, I always love it, you know. I have to say, I was a very selfish person once upon a time, you know, when I was using drugs, the only thing you care about is yourself and where your next bit of drugs are coming from. But when I found him and he was injured and he asked me for help, I had to think about someone other than myself. And this was the crux where it snapped for me, and I had to, you know, start thinking about someone other than myself, and I started taking care of him. And he repaid me with so much love and affection and absolute loyalty that I've never ever seen in any animal, let alone a cat. Right. Which cats are not generally loyal like this, you know. They're very independent usually. Covent Garden is it's a good tourist area, and there's it's just, you know, there's a good mix of like British people and tourists, and it's when you're busking, obviously it's good to have a wide variety of people, that it's always busy. And Covent Garden is one of the busiest areas in London, you know, so that's kind of why it worked. But I was doing that before I met Bob. It was just a bonus that Bob decided to come with me. I definitely say it's not so hard busking now. I mean, even when I first had Bob, you know, obviously life was a lot easier with Bob, because he attracts the people, and he's a gorgeous little man. But ever since, you know, the book's come out, it's made him a celebrity, and obviously me his celebrity keeper. So, yeah. people who are sleeping on the streets or who work on the streets or are homeless or live in hostels or any of those kind of situations, they're often overlooked by society and they become invisible. I wanted to partly show the true side of life, you know, obviously without the cat, but then also I wanted to, you know, show the joy that Bob had brought to my life and the, you know, how much love he gives me, you know. And I mean, if a cat can give that kind of love, why can't a human, you know, help, you know, in that kind of way? Because there's so much that could be done, you know, to help the homeless, but people just look the other way so often. And I wanted to express this and let people see the real side of it, not what their perceived opinions are, their perceived views, what they were, their automatic, you know, brain thing. A message for people who are hopeless. Oh, that's a toughie. Don't give up, I suppose. Just strive for excellence. And if you have family and friends, turn to them. If you don't, turn to a support worker, I suppose. But don't go out and get a cat, because that's just silly. I met him. It was a chance coincidence. I don't condone anybody going out and getting an animal just because they feel lonely, you know. This is just a strange set of circumstances that happened with us.